the start of the year, we already knew we were going to have a good year. We got a good class of freshmen coming in. The qualifying scores were outstanding. Danny Brock just came straight out the blocks, and I didn't expect him to play as well as he did. And we went to the first tournament, our heads held high, and it was an interesting format. I mean, I've never played that before. All five of our players were playing in one spot, and after 36 holes, we shot 11 under in the second round, 4 under, and we broke school records, and we were all like, we couldn't contain ourselves really. So, I mean, it was a great feeling to win the first tournament of the year. Then to go on to Rutgers, where we got high expectations, obviously winning in the last few years in a row, Adam winning every time he's ever gone to the tournament. And to go there and to expect to win and to go there and really do it is, I think that's more important than coming from nowhere and winning, because you set yourself high expectations and you achieve your goals. I think that really shows what an impressive competitor you are, and each one of the team is, I'm extremely proud of every one of them. Well, I play a lot of golf in the summer overseas, so I'm constantly competitive throughout the year. The only time I don't really play is over Christmas break. So I'd had a lot of good finishes. I won a national championship back at home. So I came back to Upstate with a lot of confidence and really wanted to prove how I could really play. And I've played as well as I could have, really. Me and Adam have got a lot of healthy competition between us. He got me last year, so we're constantly trying to beat each other. We're living together this year, so we're constantly trying to get each other up. But I think that really makes the good foundations of a good team. I mean, we all, if we beat each other, we like give each other like a harsh word or something, and it just gets the other one going. We're just constantly competing against each other, and then everyone else kind of fades into the background.
You know, every round you have to go out there and play your best. You can't worry about the competition you play against. You can't worry about, you know, whether you love the golf course, whether it's perfect condition or not. And these guys have really stepped up in these first two tournaments. And, you know, one of them we've played, you know, regularly at Rutgers, but we haven't been back to Francis Marion's tournament in a long time. In fact, several of the guys have never played in the tournament. And, you know, it's just, I think it says a lot about what they want to accomplish and who they can be individually as players to go out and you know, post the low scores regardless of who else is, you know, on the golf course. And I think, you know, there's very strong competition at both events, fields that we like to compete against and beat. And in the past, quite honestly, we've struggled getting those wins against those fields. You know, it's great to start out that way. I don't think we've ever started out winning two in a row. I don't think we've ever won two in a row. And more importantly, you know, we've beaten, you know, nearly 25 different Division I teams. It's not like we've gone to two tournaments and seen the same 10 teams and shot the same numbers. We went two different places, two different types of golf courses, different weather conditions, everything. Very proud. It was a neat banter last year, a little healthy competition amongst the two of them to see who could play the hardest, to see who could post that score. It's nice to have, you know, an inter-team competition that's healthy. You know, neither one of them is worried about a spot of how they can knock each other out of traveling or whatever. They're worried about doing their best and posting the numbers that they're capable of. And then the fun is after the round when they haven't seen each other about those conversations, and that's a really neat experience. But, you know, being roommates and Adam has definitely taken Ryan and put him in a position to understand what he's been through over the last three or four years. And Ryan's got incredible experiences from his tournament play in the UK, and he brings an element that that you don't see necessarily all the time here in U.S. amateur and collegiate golf. And it's a great combination, and it's going to be fun to continue to watch their competitiveness and how hard they work. He has, you know, Danny has always been a phenomenal athlete, great striker of the ball, one of the prettiest swings we've had. But I think sometimes mentally on the golf course in preparation in previous tournaments, he has taken a step back to some of the seniors who were his friends and roommates, and a very personable, easygoing guy. But I think he understands that, you know, not only have they graduated, but his opportunity is there and that we need him. And, you know, when somebody steps up in that competition role, it's nice. It's one thing when you have, you know, your own expectations to go out there and do well and to finish in the top, you know, of a field, regardless of who it is. I mean, he won the South Carolina match play, finished amazingly at the Ocean Course over the summer. This is not a guy that just goes out and plays small college Division I golf. He plays with whoever. he'll play whenever. He loves to practice, loves to compete. And, you know, other players on our team see that. They see that energy and that passion for golf. And, you know, when you can deliver results on top of your work ethic, you know, that naturally makes you a leader. But he also has stepped into a role as a senior that he understands that there is a lot of talent that is younger than him. And he's willing to talk to them, play with them, you know, in a sport that it really is hard to adapt when you're going your own way, hitting your own shots and things. But he's reached out, and I think he's done a wonderful job of connecting with those new players.